watching PTS, Ingenious Arm Shen Lu Pei, County Selected Candidate Yan Kuan Heng went along on November 18th to register formally for the Taichung by-election.
Former legislator Yan Kuan Heng came alone to Taichung City Election Committee to collect his registration form and paid his deposit to formally register as a KMT candidate for the by-election in Taichung City's second constituency. Yan said this is his first time registering alone and the beginning of a new task. He will start campaigning in the local area, and coastal residents are his biggest supporters.
面对于整个政党执政党，一个大军压境。 然后呢，对于海线屯区，所有乡亲的指责，以及对于我个人的批评，我能够依靠的，以及我们的团队，就是我们海线屯区所有的乡亲。
Yan expressed respect for the doubts and criticisms raised by the radio personality Clara Zhou, but he will take necessary legal actions if it involves rumor spreading and smearing. DPP candidate Lin Jingyi also held a press conference on anti-bribery elections on the 18th. She said that coastal residents hope for a change to old, entrenched political factions.
台中第二选区的选民越来越清楚地知道民主制度赋予大家就是能够 充分辨别他想要投给怎么样的候选人，选择未来什么样的价值。他们也知道有很多旧的结构跟旧的势力，但是他们更期待新的改变在这个地方。Lin
believes what citizens want is a clean election, and that the Yan family's power and factions have lost their influence on the local area. This election should not be affected by gambling. Kindergarten principal Lin Jinglian, who was the first to announce his candidacy, could not be reached before the registration deadline.
The second referendum presentation was held, which challenged the algorithm. The poll side and the opposition representative continue to attack and defend.
The 20th referendum chair's the Algo Reef appeared first in the second referendum presentation. The pro side is represented by Tsai Ya-ying, a lawyer from Taiwan Wild at Heart Legal Defense Association. She pointed out the dangerous sea conditions around Datan Algo Reef and questioned the safety of the natural gas receiving station. Opposition representative Zhao Jiawei, the chairperson of the Taiwan Environment and Planning Association, also came prepared.
中油就曾经评估这里的海象太差，潮差过大，安全操作天数太短，而选择到其他地方开发。而学者也曾经分析，大潭这里是台湾北部最不安全的接收站场址。其实很多都是引用中兴大学庄炳贤老师的分析，而庄炳贤老师目前都已经接受这个在外推方案，他在可利用天数上面心得估算，他也愿意出来支持在外推方案。
Tsai has repeatedly emphasized that the Algo Reef referendum has never been anti-natural gas, but rather, it's about the rational selection of a proper site. She also pointed out that natural gas power generation is a transitional plan for the government to develop green energy. It is hoped that the government will not only focus on short-term goals, but also question the arguments put forward by the opposition representatives.
确实，我这份资料是引用赵家伟博士的资料，他告诉我们，天然气大概到2030年的时候就要需要开始削减。我们想要问的是，既然知道这些天然气只是一个过渡的设施，为什么非在三阶这里大潭这里不可？我们就算是我们的永安接收站跟台中接收站。
在如期扩建、如期完成，在2025年的时候如期完成，他们在2025年时候能够提供的供气量，大概也是2050万吨左右，这跟我们要达到的，我们当年所需求的2490万吨来讲话，有一个很大的落差。
Zhao emphasized that natural gas must be used to reduce coal usage and nuclear power. Coal usage will inevitably arise if the receiving stations are not built. The pro side proposed an alternative site of Taipei Port, which the opposition side claimed isn't feasible. Both sides have their arguments for economic and ecological trade-offs.
Vice Premier Shen Rongjing is being blasted for violating administrative neutrality and promoting the government's referendum at a public event. Central Election Commission Li Jingyao explained the government officials are involved in referendums, so Shen has his illegal rights to promote government agendas in public.
Vice Premier Shen Rongjing has been roundly criticized for promoting the government's referendum agendas at a recent networking event held by Aerospace Industrial Development Corporation. Central Election Commission Chair Li Jingyong says government officials are involved in referendums and not third parties, and Shen was within his rights doing what he did. The Ministry of Justice took it one step further, saying when it comes to referendums, government officials can't say whatever they want, but must say what they should. New Power Party lawmaker Chou Xianzhi, meanwhile, says countries all over the world don't see an issue with holding referendums alongside general elections, and pointed out Kaohsiung City Mayor Chen Qimai and Premier Su Zhenchang were previously proponents of holding elections and referendums together. Chou asked why Taiwan now wants to walk its own path. In response, Li said he is not at liberty to discuss his personal views. He also claimed holding elections and referendums separately is the wish of every election worker in Taiwan. Chou says logistical issues are the only hindrance to holding the two together and says Taiwan can follow the U.S.'s single ballot model. Li also said law enforcement will be on the lookout for anyone who makes noise or disturbs the referendum or induces others to vote or not to vote within 30 meters around the polling station, which is against the law.
Now bringing some other stories from around Taiwan. The world's first F-16B fighter squadron held a launch ceremony at Jiayi Air Force Base. President Tsai Ing-wen personally hosted the event, and the AIT director Sandra Ocker also attended. In the 2019 school year, the total return rate of drop-off across the country reached 87.63%. Junior high school tutors revealed helping children find their interest is to not give up. The KMT Central Committee passed a plan for members to return to the party, including provisions through lesser party discipline. The legislator Fu Kunqi said he has nothing to do with this plan. A Taichung traditional medicine clinic was found to be knowingly selling herbs contained with lead and cinnabar last year. One of the 46 victims, woman Sernian Zhang, died earlier this month.
Taichung's Shentong Chinese Medicine Clinic was found to be knowingly selling medicinal herbs contaminated with lead and cinnabar last year, poisoning 46 patients. Many of the patients are still going through detox protocols today. One of the 46, a woman surnamed Zhang, died earlier this month. Zhang was being treated at the clinic for breast cancer. The chief practitioner of the clinic, Liu Shiming, gave her medication contaminated with lead, which accelerated the metastasis of Zhang's cancer. On the 18th, victims and their families said the clinic had the money to hire three high-priced lawyers, but refused to give a single cent to its victims. The lawyer representing the victims, Luo Yong'an, says this type of large-scale pharmaceutical poisoning suit is rare. Unfortunately for the victims, the government has chosen not to order any toxicity identification evaluations for the use of prosecutors in courts. The victims are therefore seeking assistance from the Institute of Forensic Medicine.
嘱托法医研究所来鉴定，好。 有没有加速，终结的这种情况，法医研究所在以前的部分的实务案例，其实是会接受鉴定的。
Liu's professional license has been revoked and he has not responded to media requests. The death of Ms. Zhang has galvanized the surviving victims in their quest for justice.
Now bring you some other stories from around the world. Greek police deploy about 6,000 officers hover over the city as thousands of people march to commemorate a 1973 protest when the army cracked down on students opposing military rule. Hong Kong authorities said about 30 ball attacks have been reported in recent years, so they utilized 7 white balls as the government began a campaign to reduce their numbers in urban area. Harry Potter stars Daniel Radcliffe, Emma Watson and Rupert Grant are reuniting with other cast members from the blockbuster film franchise for the special 20th anniversary TV retrospective. Many people are used to eating sesame oil chicken and ginger duck in winter. Kaohsiung Police Department set up sobriety tests for 9 consecutive days starting on the 14th. In just 4 days, 257 drunk driving cases were recorded.
Pour in the rice wine and set a fire to burn off the alcohol. Winter is here. Sesame oil, shochu chicken, and even ginger duck are all tonic foods. Rice wine is often added to these dishes, causing people to accidentally exceed blood alcohol standards. This man in Kaohsiung was stopped by the police when he crossed a yellow light on his motorcycle on the 16th. The police found his alcohol test value exceeded the standard and reached 0.46.
This is Gabi Junya.
The man recalled that 2 bottles of rice wine were added to the soup. He was then prosecuted for drunk driving. According to statistics from Chi San Precinct, 7 cases of drunk driving have been recorded in the jurisdiction in the 2 days between the 16th and the 17th. A total of 31 cases have been recorded since the beginning of November this year, compared to 18 cases in the same period last year, an increase of 13 cases.
各类饮酒场所逐步的解封，加上适逢禁捕时节，那许多民众都会相约吃麻油鸡，食物经常会加入米酒来提味，民众的酒驾件数也有升高的趋势。
The increase in drunk driving is related to winter's arrival and the slowing of the domestic epidemic. Kaohsiung police will be setting up sobriety tests for 9 consecutive days starting from the early morning of the 14th. Kaohsiung has recorded 257 drunk driving cases in the 4 days from November 12th to November 16th.
Thank you for watching PTS Insu News. I'm Shen Lupei. See you next time. We'll be right back.